This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead.
Viper-eyed Hellraiser.
Sewed his head back on.
Down sits an old oak tree. Through and cider.
But Tosley said he'd not give his dog this water.
Down in greedy slut. Then come
sure to be poison.
Double head hurt.
Not so sure. Who knows? I can hovel instead.
Not in your life.
Got a lump of bread today.
Your mug. punch hour!
You did! Scurvy mutants! Gonna kill ya!
in later once it's safe.
Do that often? Talk to your dog?
It's my brother's, Bastian's. But guess he's mine now. See, Bastian fought the Black Ones in a battle just outside the village. Haven't had word of him since. I told him, do like I did, lose a finger or two so they won't recruit you. Too damn afeard he was. Bloody hell.
I'd walk the battlefield if I were you.
I did. Sea of corpses. And corpsers feeding. Someone told me they're afeard of fire, so I took a torch, tried to chase them off. Horse shite, I tell you. Would have ended up eaten alive if it weren't for Hussar here. Listen, guessing you carry those swords for more than show. Come with me. Keep the ghouls off. Help me find Bastian and I'll pay you well.
Fine, I'll help you. Just been a few days since the battle. Chances we find your brother alive are slim. Very slim.
I would have thought, but I want to find his body at least. So Bastian don't rot there in the sun with the Black Ones. Meet me on the hill overlooking the battlefield. We'll move on together from there.
Thank you. Get up!
Bad idea.
Blow yourself! Poor son!
Thank you.
him catch his breath! He's ours! A cunt's ours!
Everything's gonna be fine.
What?
Got anything interesting? Farewell.
Could you deliver us from evil?
Given me no choice.
Thank you.
magic. A place of power. journal might be useful. Magic. A place of power. Humming. Place of power, it's gotta be.
Shit in a blowhole.
May the sun shine upon you.
Lost your key, ma'am?
No, not me key. Me pan. It always sat there empty, this hurt. That is, till the night afore the battle. A man arrived, walked right in like 'twere his own. Was standing at me window, peering at the goings on. He must have eyed me, 'cause next I knew, there he was, coming my way. So, I grabbed me pan, for protection, see? But he just asks all polite. Gran, Got any birch bark, by chance? Lilac berries or even a few coals? Nay, says I. And you must be right daft to pester folk at night with such foolery.
But I sees you ain't listening. Just staring at me pan like a magpie at a copper. Lend it to me, Gran. I'll give it back come morn. Was right baffled for what's he doing, frying in the dark. But I've got a soft heart, so I gave it to him.
Interesting. What happened then?
Afore dawn, another rode up to the hut. But come morn, only the first fella left. Locked the door, hopped on his horse, and that were all I saw of him, and me pan. 'Twere old, black with soot, not worth much, I suppose, but I've no other. Will you help me, dearie? Bring an old widower pan. I could never break down that door myself. And in truth, I'm afeard to go in any road. Such a stench wafting out. Methinks the other fellow, well, that he's lying there.
Never taken on a pan contract. Fine, I'll go in, look around.
You should wait here, just in case.
A corpse. Explains the stench. His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind a soldier might have.
What's that, dearie?
Nothing, nothing. Documents. Almost entirely burnt. A few pieces still legible.
When I gab to myself, they say I'm going barmy.
Ah, the priceless frying pan. Scrubbed clean. Looks like the mystery man didn't need the pan so much as the soot off it to make ink, write letters.
Found the pan, have ye?
His throat. He was garroted. And some old scars. Kind a soldier might have.
Bye. pan, have ye?
Here, your frying pan.
Mine? But mine were black with soot, and I could see myself in this one if I wanted. But them years are past.
It was the soot the man needed. He scraped it off to make ink. Must have had an urgent letter to write. Urgently burned some other documents, too.
And the other fellow?
Dead. Round up a few boys and bury him outside the village. Deep, so the necrophages don't dig him up. And take my advice. Don't mention this to the Nilfgaardians.
Hang about! You've earned a token of thanks. Here, sonny, for the road.
Fry up a nice white fish for supper. Or a pipe.
Storm, damn it.
Let it rain. Wash the blood from the fields.
Thank you.
like that silver.
Rain don't rust your blades.
You know, Witcher, folk can say what they will. Me, I'll never forget what I did for us.
Treblin.
Greetings.
Wouldn't mind a look at your stock. Farewell.
Your blades.
Thank you.
numbers to work!
Not good.
Dead!
magic. A place of power. What happened?
Monsters. Monsters from the swamp. Folk said the road was fraught with peril, but I wouldn't listen. Got my comeuppance now.
Less moaning, more details. What happened, and how can I help? And remember, I don't work for free. Witcher's code and all.
Well, was on my way to the Black Ones to trade. Suddenly my horse got spooked. Ran clear off the road. We hit a bump. I went flying and the horse and cart rolled on. Then I heard bubbling, neighing, slurping. Something came out from the muck. Devoured Asher, hooves and all. No doubt my goods are still on the cart, but I'm too afeard to go and see. Thought maybe you... I'm most concerned about a little box. Bring it to me. I beg you.
Fine, I'll go. Let you know if I find that box. Into the swamp. Well, how long you gonna make me wait? Here's the cart. Carts riddled with arrows. Interesting. I should take a look around. An arrow. Didn't mention this. square in the neck. Good shot. Either the merchant's got serious memory problems, or he's lying. Must be that box he mentioned. Splattered with blood. Human blood.
Oh, and you find the box?
Yeah, found your priceless chest. And someone who looks an awful lot like a cart driver with an arrow through his neck. No dryads in these swamps, and never known a drowner or a water hag to use a bow. So lacking any other suspects, I'm guessing.
Watch out! Behind you!
There's nothing behind me. I'm a witcher, I'd have heard it. Just like I can hear your heart, which is pounding, like a liar's. Best hope you're a better rider than you are a liar.
Come on.
This bard's tale begins near White Orchard, with my dear friend Geralt of Rivia seeking his lover of yore, the sorceress Yennefer. She'd eluded him for years, but now seemed just a few steps ahead.
Oh, and you find the box?
Yeah, found your priceless. No dryads in the...
Watch out!
There's nothing behind. Best hope you're a better rider than you are a liar.
Thank you.
surrender. Gotta get him out of here. Wake up. See, can't run from the truth. Not even on horseback. Now, who are you, and why'd you attack that cart?
Private First Class John Girmer. Temerian 6th Division, 2nd Regiment. Disbanded, but still active. Underground, in the woods. That was a medical transport. I'd be damned if it reached the Black Ones. And the medicine, our lads could use it too. We've many ill among us. You let me go, and they might live and fight once more for a free North.
Fine. Go. And may you and your soldier buddies hiding in the bushes be victorious in your struggle against Nilfgaard.
You've a vile sense of humor. But you're a decent man. Here, the gold I promised. Use it well. Drink to the silver lilies and to Foltest's memory.
May the sun shine upon ye.
Magic. A place of power.
Thank you.
place of power, it's gotta be